In this video, we are going to talk about what to do with the money you are saving up now that you have moved to Canada and have started earning, or if you have brought some extra amount with you. To give you a heads up, we will talk about four main types of accounts, which are checking account, savings account, TFSA, and RRSP. And very briefly, we will be touching on some other investment products as well. So I'm Nishant.
And I'm Tanu, and let's get started. So the first step to get started with your banking in Canada is to open a checking account and also a savings account. Remember, India में ज़्यादातर लोगों के पास सिर्फ एक ही account होता है, called a savings account. इसी account में आपने जो पैसे रखे होते हैं, उस पे bank आपको interest देता है, and इसी account में आपकी salary भी आती है direct deposit से, इसी से आप withdrawals भी करते हो, और इसी से अपनी online shopping वगैरह भी करते हो. लेकिन कनाडा में बैंकिंग सिस्टम थोड़ा अलग एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स है. इसी काम के लिए यहाँ पर आप दो तरीके के अकाउंट्स खोलते हो, वन अ चेकिंग अकाउंट एंड आल्सो अ सेविंग्स अकाउंट. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दीज इन डिटेल.
अ चेकिंग अकाउंट इज बेसिकली अ ट्रांजैक्शनल बैंक अकाउंट. मतलब आपके जितने भी पेचेक्स हैं फ्रॉम योर वर्क विल बी डिपॉजिटेड इन दिस अकाउंट. आप अपने ATM विड्रॉल्स, बिल पेमेंट्स, क्रेडिट कार्ड के बिल पेमेंट्स भी इसी चेकिंग अकाउंट से करोगे. और इस चेकिंग अकाउंट में 0% इंटरेस्ट मिलता है. मतलब इंटरेस्ट मिलता ही नहीं है, बिकॉज ये अकाउंट बना ही सिर्फ ट्रांजैक्शनल पर्पस के लिए है. एंड अनलाइक इंडिया, यहाँ पे बैंक अकाउंट मेंटेन करना थोड़ा सा एक्सपेंसिव है. मंथली फीस लगती है विच वेरीज फ्रॉम $3 टू इवन $30 पर मंथ, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द फैसिलिटीज इन योर चेकिंग अकाउंट.
लेकिन आप ये मंथली फीस अवॉइड कर सकते हो बाय मेंटेनिंग अ सर्टेन बैलेंस, फॉर एग्जांपल $2,000 or $3,000 पर डे इन योर चेकिंग अकाउंट एंड मीटिंग सम अदर कंडीशंस दैट वेरीज फ्रॉम बैंक टू बैंक. सो मेंटेनिंग अ बैलेंस इन योर चेकिंग अकाउंट इज नॉट ऑलवेज अ बैड आइडिया. चाहे आपको इस पे इंटरेस्ट नहीं मिलता, लेकिन इट हेल्प्स यू अवॉइड द मंथली फी. A savings account is a bank account which gives you interest for maintaining a balance, but it is still not meant for your day-to-day transactions. For most savings account, you can withdraw and deposit money whenever you want, but the number of free transactions is limited. By transactions, I mean, for example, taking out cash from ATM from your savings account or making a bill payment with your savings account. If you go over the limited number of free transactions, you will be charged with a fee. So we suggest for any transaction, use your checking account instead of your savings account.
But अब आप सोच रहे होंगे कि if I want to make a transaction for which I do not have sufficient funds in my checking account, तो मैं क्या करूँ? क्या मैं savings account से transaction कर सकता हूँ? तो yes, as we said earlier, कि savings account से भी transaction की जा सकती है, but आप एक महीने में कितनी free transaction कर सकते हो, वो limited होता है. So yes, in case of emergency, अगर आपके checking account में पैसे नहीं हैं या sufficient funds नहीं हैं, तो आप savings account से भी transaction कर सकते हो. But what I would suggest is, कि आप अपने savings account से checking account में पहले पैसे transfer करो, and then make your transaction through the checking account itself. Because checking account में कोई limitation नहीं होती, आप कितनी भी transactions कर सकते हो. Plus, transferring funds from your savings to your checking account or vice versa is completely free and very convenient, और आप बहुत easily अपने online banking से वो कर सकते हो.
Now let's discuss कि savings account पे interest मिलता कितना है. So your usual brick and mortar bank will pay you less than 1% interest. Yes guys, India की तरह यहाँ पे 4-5% का interest rate नहीं होता savings account पे. Most banks will have less than 1% interest. In fact, at present it is only 0.05%. Which means if you keep $10,000 in your bank account, in your savings account for an entire year, you'll get a return of $5 only. Yes guys, if you keep $10,000, you're getting a return of $5 only. And if the inflation is say 2%, then your purchasing power is basically getting eaten away if you're keeping all of your money in just a savings account.
अब आप ये सेविंग्स अकाउंट के इंटरेस्ट रेट सुन के थोड़ा घबरा गए होंगे, बट डोंट वरी, देयर आर अ फ्यू सेविंग्स अकाउंट विच प्रोवाइड 1-2% ऑफ रिटर्न एंड दे आर कॉल्ड हाई इंटरेस्ट सेविंग्स अकाउंट हेयर इन कैनेडा. दे आर बेसिकली द ऑनलाइन बैंक्स विच यूजुअली डू नॉट हैव ब्रांचेस, सो दे यूज दीज सेविंग्स बाय नॉट हैविंग अ फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू प्रोवाइड यू अ बेटर रिटर्न एज कम्पेयर टू द यूजुअल बैंक्स. बट दे टू जनरली प्रोवाइड 1-2% ऑफ रिटर्न ओनली, विच अगेन इज नॉट दैट ग्रेट. but yeah, better than the usual bank, so at least it is a good starting point. And don't worry, these banks are safe too. They are CDIC insured, which means that you are protected up to $100,000 if your bank goes bankrupt. But there are some banks which may not be CDIC insured, so you need to check that on the CDIC website itself before choosing a bank for yourself. We have provided the link in the description box below.
So these were the two basic banking accounts in Canada, that is your savings account and your checking account. But there are two main investments account as well in Canada. So, जैसे इंडिया में हम सेविंग्स अकाउंट के अलावा एफ डी भी करवाते हैं एंड प्रोविडेंट फंड खुलवाते हैं, वैसे कैनेडा में द टू मेन इन्वेस्टमेंट अकाउंट्स आर टी एफ एस ए एंड आर आर एस पी. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैम. टी एफ एस ए स्टैंड्स फॉर टैक्स फ्री सेविंग्स अकाउंट. इट इज़ अ रजिस्टर्ड अकाउंट एंड एनी वन हुज 18 ईयर्स ऑफ एज एंड हैज़ अ वैलिड सिन नंबर कैन ओपन दिस अकाउंट. Any money you put in this account is not tax deductible, which means if you make a contribution in this account, it will not reduce your marginal tax rate. But any interest or any capital gain that you get on this account is not taxable, which means when you take out the money from this account, you will not have to pay any tax.
One other great feature of TFSA is its flexibility in terms of when you can withdraw the money. So you are free to withdraw at any time without paying any penalty. But there is a limit on how much you can contribute in your TFSA every year. Currently, at the time of shooting this video, which is the year 2020, this limit is $6,000. So make sure you do not over-contribute, because if you did, then there is a penalty that you will have to pay. But if you contribute less than $6,000, then the remaining contribution room you can carry forward to the next year. मतलब ये है कि suppose 2020 में आपने सिर्फ $4,000 ही contribute करे अपने TFSA में out of the $6,000 which is the maximum limit, तो जो remaining $2,000 है वो आपका एक contribution room बन जाता है which you can carry forward to the next year, that is 2021. So for the year 2021, assuming that the standard contribution limit remains the same, which is $6,000, तो आपका total contribution limit actually में $8,000 हो जाएगा. कैसे? $6,000 is the standard contribution limit plus the $2,000 which is the contribution room that you carried forward from the 2020.
Now guys, you must be thinking कि TFSA में return मिलता कितना है? Well, the simple answer is it depends on what you choose to do with the money that you put in your TFSA. Your TFSA is a tax-free savings account, but it is not your regular savings account. You can think of it like a briefcase or a basket, whichever you want to call it. You can pick and choose what to put in this basket from a wide variety of financial instruments such as stocks, bonds, mutual funds, GICs, ETFs, and even cash too. So ultimately, the return that you get on your TFSA will depend on how well the financial instruments are doing which you chose to put in this TFSA.
We know guys, ये थोड़ा confusing है. ये ऐसी चीज़ नहीं है कि किसी ने आपको एक बार लिख के दे दी या बस मुँह ज़बानी बता दी तो सब कुछ समझ में आ जाएगा. Once you get your hands dirty, जब आप खुद से अपना एक TFSA account खुलवाओगे, उसमें investments करना शुरू करोगे, तभी आपको धीरे धीरे सब कुछ समझ में आने लगेगा. But in this video, our purpose was to make you all aware of what all options you have and to make you familiarized with all these concepts and their fundamentals. But in our next video, we will be discussing about TFSA and RRSP in detail. So do check that out. But for now, let's move to RRSP and discuss that in brief. RRSP is Registered Retirement Savings Plan. It is another registered investment account, which is very similar to TFSA in terms of how it operates, but very different in its purpose and its approach. RRSPs are tax deductible, meaning any amount you contribute in your RRSP will be exempt from your income tax, so it actually reduces your marginal tax. So let's say if you earn $50,000 in a year and you contribute $9,000 in your RRSP, which is basically 18% of $50,000. So I'll explain it later why I specifically said 18%. But now coming back, this $9,000 RRSP contribution will actually reduce your taxable income by another $9,000. मतलब आपको tax $50,000 पे नहीं लगेगा, आपको tax $41,000 पे लगेगा. RRSP also has a contribution limit which varies year by year. For the year 2020, it is up to a maximum of $27,230 or 18% of your last year's income, whichever is smaller. And like a TFSA, in RRSP also, you can carry forward your contribution room to the future years. And again, just like a TFSA, you can consider the RRSP to be like a suitcase in which you can put a wide range of financial instruments. But this basket is a little different because it is designed for saving for your retirement. So it is not as flexible as TFSA in terms of withdrawing your money. And whenever you make a withdrawal out of your RRSP, it will be considered your income and you will be taxed on that amount.
Now, there's much more to RRSP and TFSAs, and as we said earlier, we will make a detailed video about them, so do watch it when the video is out. And we also thought that we should cover two other investment accounts. These are not that common, but they might be useful. These are called RESP, which is Registered Education Savings Plan, and RDSP, which is a Registered Disability Savings Plan. So let's discuss about these in detail.
RESPs are the registered accounts to be used to save for your child's post-secondary education. The funds in the RESP can be invested in countless ways, just like in TFSA or RRSP. And if you spend this amount on higher education related expenses, then no capital gains that you receive in this account will be subject to income tax. One more benefit of opening this RESP account are the grants given by the government, and these are called Canada Education Savings Grant, CESG. So for the first $2,500 that you put in the RESP, government will put $500 too per year per child, up to a maximum of $7,200 for the entire life of this plan. And as long as both the account opener or the beneficiary are Canada residents, it doesn't matter who opens the account. It could be the child's parent, grandparent, or the friends of the family, etc.
Now let's talk about RDSP, which stands for Registered Disability Savings Plan. Now we hope कि आप में से किसी को भी इस अकाउंट को यूज करने की जरूरत ना पड़े, लेकिन अगर नॉलेज हो तो किसी और की अवेयरनेस में आप हेल्प कर सकते हो. So RDSP is a savings plan designed to help disabled adults and parents of disabled children save a significant amount of money for expenses later in life. And just like an RESP, the money put in the RDSP grows tax-free, and the government also contributes to this account in the form of grants. We just wanted to introduce you guys to RESPs and RDSPs, but if you want more information and if you want advice specific to your situation, we recommend that you talk to a financial service representative or a financial advisor.
Right. And in this video, we talked about savings account, checking account, and various other registered investment accounts as well. So if you have any questions, then please comment down below. And agar aapko ye video informative lagi ho, then please smash the like button and encourage us by subscribing to our channel if you haven't already. Till then,
take care and stay safe.